The default texture mapping for Morph elements is the box method. With this method, textures are projected onto every face of the Morph element either horizontally or vertically, even onto slanted faces. This way, the proportions of the texture get distorted on slanted surfaces, as can be seen on the slanted surface of this Morph element. If we look perpendicular to the slanted surface of the Morph element, we can see that the square tile texture has been distorted on the slanted surface because of the horizontal projection. The other texture mapping option, the planar option, handles such situations. The texture mapping field of the model panel in the Morph Settings dialog box shows what texture is currently being applied. By default, it's grayed when all faces of the Morph element have the same box setting applied to them. If we select one or more faces of the Morph and go to the Settings dialog, the field becomes enabled and may be set to the planar option. If we now set the option to planar and click the OK button to accept the change, we can see that our Morph face shows the square tile pattern correctly, since there's no distortion involved in the planar option. When we now activate the settings dialog with the whole Morph element selected, the texture mapping field contains the value various. The yellow icon to the left indicates that there are custom texture mappings for some of the faces of the Morph element. By setting the field to the box value again, the default setting can be restored for the Morph element.